Hello, my name is Chris Palmer, and in today's Google My Business video, I want to discuss Google My Business tips, tactics, and hacks that will help increase your Google My Business rankings and visibility in 2020. So there are six tips, six bullet points that I want to touch on in today's video that I will walk you through. And if you stick until the end, I have a grayer hat tip that it will get your wheels turning. So first and foremost, what I want to touch on is the amounts of edits that you are performing on your account. Edits that are being done on a numerous basis, you will come to find that accounts are getting suspended, accounts are getting shut down. It's taking longer and longer for the edits to take effect. So over the course of time, I have actually found a particular number that will guarantee safety and something that you can implement every 24 to 48 hours. So the magic number after you have set up and optimized your account fully, all in that first day when you set it up, if you're new to GMBs, is 4. Now I have noticed that you can get away with 5, but if you do 4 edits every 24 to 48 hours, you will notice that they will go into immediate effect and none will be pending. You will not have to wait. So the magic number is 4. Now the next tip is for anyone that has a main business location, but you may also service other business areas. Now this could be for a gray hat as well, because if you have a verified listing and one verified account, you can also within that same account have a service area business listed as well. You can basically have 2. And what's absolutely wonderful about having your brick and mortar verified location and then having another GMB that is a service based is you could start showing up for more searches and you can start getting more impressions. So now that we're on the gray hat of Google My Business and GMBs, there's something that really comes to mind. And what that is SIP and trunking services. You're probably wondering, Chris, what is a SIP or trunking? Well, SIP and trunking is actually a virtual phone number. Now, I've talked about in the past about virtual offices, which are really becoming obsolete because there is literally a squad out there looking for these types of listings. Anytime that you have a business or a service-based business that will have a brick and mortar location and you can show signage, along with that maybe some tax ID information. But the next piece and the next step to verify these locations and to make sure that these listings are following the guidelines is you need to have their own phone number. Now, this is gonna be 2 tips in 1. What I wanna tell you, if you're running a grayer hat campaign and you're getting accounts shut down or flagged, it's because of your SIP and your trunking service. It's virtual phone numbers. One of my 2 tips is this. If you are using a service that is mentioned anywhere on any marketing forums, local forums, if any marketer has ever used an SIP trunking service, a virtual phone number service, and you know that they've used it, do not use that service. There are a lot of very popular virtual phone number providers out there, and this is one of the leading causes to get your accounts flagged because these SIPs, these numbers, are being picked up by the spam police. Might I suggest that you look for a very lesser known service that no marketer has ever touched. Now, the second tip within the same format of SIP and virtual phone numbers, this number for every single call, no matter what, make sure you answer the phone because generally people will call to verify these numbers. So if you're having someone answer the phone or if you're answering the phone, your wife, whomever, make sure that they are coached on what to do if someone calls asking about the business or if Google calls so you do not get your listing suspended. Now let's go ahead and talk about reviews, bad reviews, people removing spam, but more precisely, I want to talk about removing bad reviews. Now one way, and I'm sure you've heard of lots of other ways, but one surefire way to remove bad reviews from a Google My Business listing is if you are receiving bad reviews from the cause of bad publicity or bad press, Google will remove those bad reviews. So, if you have some reviews that are starting to pop up, might I suggest putting out some press releases that you control so you could start getting some of these bad reviews removed because they were based on the press release publicity that was being promoted about you. Something that you can control and take down. So if you are very concerned about reviews and you have to get rid of them, this is just one way, one opportunity to go ahead and do that. Now, another thing is, and this is the next tip that I want to talk about, monitoring these listings, especially if you have a lot of locations, is very difficult. API from Google for Google My Business is completely free. And there's a lot of resources and tools out there that you can use that use that API so you can monitor your multiple listings. What I want to talk about finally, before I get into something that could potentially get your wheels spinning if you are running a gray hat campaign, is links. Now, links for a organic campaign are absolutely wonderful and they help increase rankings over the course of time if you're getting the right links at the right time from the right people at the right velocity. And that makes sense. However, if you are sending links to your Google My Business, you are doing your listing or your client's listing a disservice. Might I suggest to cease all link building to Google My Business listings because it is non-beneficial. In fact, it could potentially be demoting your Google My Business listing. All right, and last but not least, and of course this is all hypothetical, but there might need to be roads or locations that really need to be added to better benefit users for the future. So if we have a typical map, and this is a normal business, and this is a normal business, and this is a real street, and this is a real street, how do you think that a lot of this data gets in there? A lot of this is user generated or submitted through particular programs. What if you were able to create and have your very own development, right? Say this is a brand new development and say there are locations in here. Or if you don't want to do that, let's say that you just want to add a street that's in a commercial district so you can have a business. But maybe you don't want one, maybe you want two. Say this is another one and this is another one. Did you know that there are programs out there such as Street View Trusted Pros? Did you know that pretty much anybody can sign up for this? What if you were able to get on this list? What if there's already people on this list that are willing to do these types of services? Now, first and foremost, before doing this, it goes in a cycle. Now, first and foremost, I would assume that it needs to be added as a new road. And then, of course, verified by a trusted pro. But what if you were able to start and create your own developments? What if you were able to add your own roads? What if you were able to create your own business locations, your own streets? I wonder. Now, this is just a for instance. It's just something that I found. It was just a little added bonus. But in any case, my name is Chris Palmer. If you have any local SEO questions, Google My Business, Google Maps, really anything at all, any questions or optimization questions, please leave it in the comments below. And I look forward to seeing you in the next Google My Business, Google Maps video. Have a wonderful day.